this video, we'll be exploring the concept of horror in regards to storytelling and its many formats. What I want us to think about is the macabre, the psychological, and the almost therapeutic quality of horror. But before we move on to that, what is horror? Primarily inspired by writers such as Edgar Allan Poe, Bram Stoker, Mary Shelley, and having the metaphorical torch carried on by writers such as H.P. Lovecraft. In this video, we'll be exploring the concept of horror in regards to storytelling and its many formats. What I want us to think about is the macabre, the psychological, and the almost therapeutic quality of horror. But before we move on to that, what is horror? Primarily inspired by writers such as Edgar Allan Poe, Bram Stoker, Mary Shelley, and having the metaphorical torch carried on by writers such as H.P. Lovecraft, Thomas Ligotti, Laird Barron, and Stephen King, etc., it very much remains an important form of literature, as well as connected to mainstream popular culture. And in an essay that I discovered recently, written by Orson Scott Card, in the book Maps in a Mirror, he talks about the three stages of horror in fiction. He talks about the concept of dread, terror, and horror. Firstly, he states that dread is the first and strongest of the three kinds of horror, similar to Lovecraft's concept of the fear of the unknown. It is the kind of fear that preys upon your mind when you know that there is something there, but you haven't identified it yet. You can't explain it yet, but the primeval fear sits in your mind still. For example, hearing a noise in the house when you know that you are alone, or the protagonist thinking that they see something in the shadows. Terror is the second kind, the kind you experience when you identify the thing or that you begin to understand it. For example, seeing the figure of a man stepping out of the shadows with a bloody knife. And finally, horror, the weakest of all, according to Card, this being the stage after the fearful thing has occurred and you witness the aftermath, the results, the relics. For example, seeing the mutilated corpse that the killer has left behind. In my opinion, breaking down and understanding different concepts of fear and horror will help you in your horror and thriller writing. Next time you're writing a horror story, think about the concept of fear and the different stages of horror and whether or not they resolve within the narrative and what the repercussions will be. I hope this video...